Yeah, start.
Kuzampola, namaste, good morning to all respected online viewers. Long live their majesties, long live our leaders, and long live our association and friendship. Welcome to this online Ayurveda and Yoga sessions. Embassy of India, Thimphu, ICCR's Nehru Wangchuk Cultural Center. Yoga teacher, I'm KVSSN Murthy here. My true prayers to the Almighty to see all the best things to their majesties and the whole Bhutan. And before starting the recitation, just I want to give the stress on the COVID protocols. Even though you already have taken vaccinations, please try to follow the COVID protocols which have been set by the government. That is safe physical distancing, and after that, do not touch surfaces. And please remember to use sanitizers to clean the hands. Then after that, next preparation is the nozzle oils Anu Taila and Shatbindu Taila. Inside the nostrils, you can use these oils to clean the inside nostrils and to clear the mucus passage. Then second important, then next important thing is throat gargling while using salt or while using Estimadu powder or Tripala Churn to clean the throat. It's a kind of throat gargling. And oil pulling also recommended. According to your free times, you can use this oil pulling by using coconut oil or sesame oil or plain water also. And especially, I can mention that one important technique in this COVID season called steam inhalation. Before entering your home, try to see all the possibilities how to set that device, that steam inhalation device, outside of your home. Before entering the home, you can use this device for your steam inhalation. Hot air can kill that viral cells and bacterial cells very easy rather than the medicines. So it is always prevention is always good rather than cure. So that try to use this simple precaution. You can use this steam inhalation to kill their viral cells, because viral cells will be hidden in the paranasal and parasinus cavities for at least 1 day to 1.5 day. So next one is vitamin A and vitamin D and zinc based diets, which are abundantly available in local fresh green leafy vegetables and fruits and nuts and milk based items as well as and mushrooms. And next one is home ingredients called turmeric and jaggery and ilachi, garlic, ajwain seeds and hing, asafoetida and rock salt. Next one is what we call dry ginger powder or wet ginger. In your diet, you can abundantly use these techniques. And especially we have local natural products called shilajit as well as cordyceps, also very good to raise the immunity. And we have two health tonics called kada chai and golden milk, also very useful techniques to raise the immunity. And next one is chavan prash, also very important ingredient, which are having 45 different kind of Ayurvedic herbs which can boost your immunity morning ones and evening ones. You can use them with the hot milk or hot water. So let's coming to the actually recitation. This recitation actually from the Ayurvedic text. So it is saying that ahara sambhavam vastuhu rogascha ahara sambhavaha hita hita visheshascha visheshaha sukha dukkayoho. Means food is the basic element. Food is in the form of water, food is in the form of air, and food is in the form of solid foods also what we are eating. So all these are considered as a food, because our first nutrient is our breath. The second nutrient is our the water content. The third one is what we are eating, the all kind of foods. So these foods will be first factors to create health or to build the body, to build the muscle and to repair the cells. That at the same time, when this quality will be more, or when the timings will be irregular, the same food will be potential to give the disease to the body. So if you want better health and better life, try to see that our health will become through food only. Our food is our first medicine. But how we are practicing these food practices are important. Okay, in this week, as we are seeing that PCOD is especially in the age group of 11 years to 45 plus or 50 plus girls and women, repeatedly they are seeing this kind of severity in PCOD. It's a kind of water bubble structures inside the inside the fallopian tubes and inside this actually system of the menstrual cycles. So here, when once you notice this kind of irregular menstrual periods and irregular body weight weight gaining, as well as irregular skin blemishes around the neck and around the face and chin. So you can easily suspect that something is going wrong in the body. So first thing is, it may be because of hormonal imbalances, it may be because of heredity, it may be because of somewhat heavy stress and life choice and lifestyle managements. So whatever your condition is, first of all, in the food, try to go for good remedies, avoid high fat diet and try to reduce the salt levels from the food, or you can avoid the salt also. And abundantly have hot water, not cold water, hot water. And try to lower the carbohydrate levels. Then give more resting to the body, and plus workouts also important. Active life plus resting, both are important. And try to bring more hobbies into the life instead of avoiding the stress. But because once you started avoiding the stress, then mind has to work hard on that, even avoiding the stress also. It will create another stress. So try to bring more hobbies in the life. So wherever you are, see your environment, see your surroundings must be healthy. So try to create your own world to be live healthy in that own world. Today's remedies are, as we know that Ayurveda, we have many other remedies for this same Sukra Dhatu Vikari or Arthava Dosha, what we are generally saying, menstrual disorders or inside follicles inside the menstrual cycle. We have Shatavari, then second one is Tripala, third one is Naga Keshara Churna, Pushya Anuraga Churna, and after that Kanchanala Gugulu and Ashoka, and next one is Lodhara and Shuddha Bhasma. These are very simple and effective drugs in the Ayurveda which can directly give direct positive effect for the people who are having this kind of issues. Today's our simple food remedy is unpolished rice. So in your general diets, try to use unpolished rice. This will create somewhat more vitamins. So it will this Aluron layers having more vitamins, B complex vitamins. This is really good for your blood flow and secretion of the hormones. Then second one is neem plant. It is somewhat, it will see the lower the insulin levels. So try to use one or two neem leaves or neem powder or neem capsules early in the morning before your breakfast. Afternoon, only just 1 or 2 grams adding in the water. Please use these practices, and the more you are active will be, the less diseases. Please remember to keep yourself more active towards yoga practices or towards any other hobbies. So when we are meeting here the same place with the same content, Ayurveda chapter, from Monday we will see some other topic also. Let's coming to the yoga class now. And sun salutation is our regular practices. So based on the intensity of the practices, based on the repetitions of the practices, and based on the variations in the practices, so it is also advised to do the sun salutations for the people who are having PCOD and PCOS issues. But PCOD is a kind of disorder initially. If once you will neglect, it can turn to the chronic. Okay, now take a long slow inhalation, exhalation. Now coming to sun salutation with mantra chanting and sloka and bijakshara. According to your flexibility, according to your belief system, you can choose chanting and you can choose physical exercise also. Alright, coming to pranamasana, lift your both the arms up above to the head called Kailasha Mudra. Then slowly bring your pranamasana down at your chest level called Anahata Pranamasana. Om Hiranmayena Patrena Satyasyapi Hitam Mukham Tatvam Pushan Apavrunu Satya Dharmaya Drustaye. Om Hram Hrim Hrum Hraim Hraum Raha Mitra Ravi Surya Bhanu Kagapushna Hiranya Garbha Maricha Aditya Savitra Arka Bhaskaraya Namaha. Stretch the arms forward, lift your arms up, Hasta Uttanasana once,
completely pull yourself up and slightly put a back bend called Hasta Uttanasana or Ardha Chandrasana. Then keep your body straight. Once completely pull yourself up, when you have lower back issues or neck issues or high blood pressure issues or heart ailments, avoid forward bending, or remaining people can do the forward bending till the floor or till at your convenient point, and completely press the body down. Then after that, right leg will be your back leg called Aswa Sanchalanasana or Horse Riding Posture. Alright, back leg straight on the toes and join your forward leg to back leg Santulana or Dandasana. Again, stay here for a while. Then press your body down towards the floor called Ashtanga Namaskarasana or Sastanga Namaskarasana, and push your body forward and lift the body like a lifted head cobra called Bhujangasana. Lift the chin up and back leg straight on the toes and push your body completely inside called Parvatasana. And here, right leg must be your forward leg again, Aswa Sanchalanasana, horse riding posture. And after that, back leg straight on the toes and back leg knee up and join your back leg to forward leg called Padahastasana. And lift your arms and body up called Hasta Uttanasana. Once completely give a stretch, then slightly put a back bend Ardha Chandra or Ardha Chakrasana. Then after that, again keep your body straight. Pranamasana above to the head, Kailasha Mudra. Then slowly bring your Pranamasana down at your chest called Anahata Pranamasana, and lift your both the arms up, inhalation, and very slowly exhalation, wide your arms and rest them properly, then complete relaxations. Just take a long slow inhalation, exhalations. Then coming exercises will be beneficial for the people who are having this lower abdominal issues as well as diabetes also. So first, according to your knee fitness, you can choose this posture, Vajrasana, for sitting, or you can choose kneecaps also to give more support to the knees from the shocks. Right, keep your body straight. So we are doing Seshankasana variations, after that Shalabhasana and some variations. So very simple exercise here. Keep the hands forward. Then slightly rest your abdomen on the thighs. Now check your convenience and then slowly keep stretch your both the hands completely forward. Still forward, still forward, still forward. Give a maximum stretch. Then after that, completely keep your chin down on the floor and stay for a while pressing the abdomen at your thigh region. Then very slowly keep your both the arms slightly drag back. With the palm support, lift your chin and head and body. Then very slowly get up and keep your body straight. Seshankasana also good posture to control or somewhat to managing the anger and stress. And also it is some kind of effect will come in regarding beautification also to the facial organs. Okay, one long deep inhalation, exhalation. Here similar exercise we are doing with a abdominal further pressing. Very simple and effective remedies for the people who are having these PCOD issues. But according to your convenience, you can take these practices. So once close your fist with thumb outside. So keep the two knots around your lower abdominal region. Right, once completely stretch your back and chest. Then very slowly spread your abdomen completely down while creating a sensitive pressure around your abdomen without holding the breath and completely down the head towards the floor. Few seconds to stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, enough. 10, lift your chin. Then very slowly come back, come back, come back. Then take a long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. Then slowly keep your both the hands wide. For a counter pose, you can immediately choose a simple back bend by keeping your both the hands back as a pillars. Just lift your chest up, turn the shoulders back, lift your head up, take a long, slow, deep inhalations and exhalations. Again, slowly come back, keep your body straight. Take a long, slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. Right, same exercise here with a small variation. Close your one fist and keep that fist vertical at your thigh. Then second fist also close and try to add that fist to put it on the first fist. And now try to see that total two fists must go inside. It says slant. That position must be slant. Then here try to create that sensitive pressure, but somewhat extra pressure also at one part of the abdomen. But try to choose proper way of doing. Be very convenient and confident while doing this posture. So according to your convenience, so you can bend at the half or you can bend completely more also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and lift your chin and head. Then very slowly get up, then get back to normal. Then soon after that you can immediately leave the hands for stretching. Then slightly get back to the like slant posture. Once completely lift your ribcage and chest and lift your chin up, further maintain a kind of back bend here. So it will give immediate relaxation for your back, which already have involved in the forward bends. Alright, now slowly come back. Keep your body straight. One long deep inhalation. So we are doing the same Sheshankasana or somewhat Mandukasana's opposite side. So here close your two fists and keep them on one another. So set them properly on second part of the abdomen. Alright, very slowly, carefully try to bend the body completely forward and try to put the head on the floor and stay here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and lift your chin and heads. Then very slowly come back. Relaxations enough. Alright, one long pause. Again, few seconds, move the arms back and immediately lift your abdomen up. Keep your sternum straight. Obviously, it will pull the body. Then lift your chin, few seconds, stay here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Rest, relaxation. Keep your body straight. Long, slow inhalations and exhalations. Alright, similar exercise, Mandukasana, last variation. So here, close one fist. Try to wrap the hand on the first fist like a volleyball hand positions. Then here keep that total big knot below to the lower navel case at the almost lower abdominal region. Right, first lift your rib cage and very slowly, carefully bend the body forward and further press your abdomen, completely press the head and stay for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, lift your chin, then very slowly come back, resting and relaxations enough. So whatever postures we will do, that should be give some pressure on the abdomen called Mandukasana and variation, Sheshankasana and variation, Salabhasana, locust postures and bow postures and variations, Pavanamuktasana and variation. So these kind of some postures will really give effect for the people who are having these abdominal issues. According to your free time, according to the your interaction between your yoga teacher and you, and take more schedules from the yoga teacher. So here I would like to go for somewhat back bending, very simple back bending, because those will be comes under counter poses because of this forward bends. Our lower back might have been strained bit. All right, and now stand straight on the knees. So right, wide your legs, then keep hold the left heel with the left hand and right heel with the right hand. So do not lean the body back. So against your hands, against your legs, completely push your body forward and completely hang the head and stay for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, enough. Then slowly lean back. Then after that, lift your chin and head. Again, slowly come up. And relaxations enough. Alright, soon after this practices, very slowly relax your legs from the strain of the postures, because altogether knees also involved in this kind of exercises, so that it required some exercise. Just towards your right side, towards your left side, just go for your knee turns and hip turns. Alright, relaxations enough. Then take a long, slow inhalation, exhalation in Sukhadandasana. Few seconds break to give healthy break for the breath and to give somewhat relaxation for the legs and hips. Just few seconds, slant the body, lift your chin up. So between your posture to posture,
resting the body or relaxing the body or somewhat post stretches because of that previous posture. That's also important to give extra relaxation to the body. Alright, keep your body straight. Now we are at the beginning of pranayama now. So choose proper way of doing any convenient comfortable posture on any convenient surface. You can choose lotus or half lotus or folded leg variations, Vajrasana or any posture. Okay, keep your body straight, take a long pause. You can hold your knees also to keep your or you can put your chin mudra by keeping your arms stretched and put them on the knees. So before adding pranayamas in your schedules, once you will finish your yoga postures, it's also advised to give a small gap. It will be useful for your recalling punascharana or somewhat you can use this time for your relaxation time, or you can use this time for a drinking sip of water also. It is also advised to drink water, sip of small amount of water for pranayama. So let's start our pranayam, sloka, mantra and chanting. According to your free time, according to your flexibility on the belief system, you can choose mantra chanting or you can use only practices. Okay, coming to the mantra sadhan. So take a long, slow inhalation, exhalation. Om Kesavaya Swaha. ॐ माधवाय स्वाहा. ॐ नारायणाय स्वाहा. ॐ अद्य समाधि तत्फलसिद्ध्यर्थम् आसनपूर्वकान् प्राणायामदीन् करिष्ये. ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः. And then slowly keep your palms down. Again, set them on the knees to keep your back straight. And for more awareness, you can choose just finger locking position, chin mudra or any other applications to getting more awareness and concentration towards the practices. So in other words, this sloka and chanting saying that yoga practices, postures, pranayama, mudra and bandha, some advanced practices. This purpose is not only getting the physical health or immunity or metabolic activities or anti-aging. So it has a definite goal towards the spiritual upliftment, to keep ourselves fit and strong in physical level, mental level and social level. So we are doing these yoga exercises. Alright, coming to the pranayam sloka. Again, we have sloka and some chanting for the pranayams also, which has been given in the traditional text called Hatayo Pradipika. Regarding Kapalabhati and regarding Bhastrika, we have two slokas. Kapalabhati is a Kriya Abhyas. It can be do in pranayama also, but basically it is a Kriya cleaning technique, frontal brain cleaning technique. It is saying that Bastrava Loha Karasya Racha Purav Sasam Bhravav Kapalabhatir Vikyata Kapadosha Visoshini. So by filling the lungs in a separate way, or by filling the lungs with a large amount of oxygen at a time, and while releasing the total carbon dioxide at a time, so it will give some positive results in bringing the kapha dosha in the proper way. Kapha dosha means is here phlegm related issues or mucus related issues. So it is also saying that kapha dosha visoshini, whatever phlegm related errors inside the head and skull and throat and chest and ribcage, it will be calmed down or it will be nullified. But the way how we are doing also important. So next one is Bhastrika Pranayama. It is also saying that Vata Pitta Slashma Haram Sariragni Vivardhanam Kundali Bodhakam Kshipram Pavanam Sukadam Hitam Brahma Nadi Mukhe Samasta Kapadhyar Gala Nasanam. It is saying that wind related issues, mucus related issues and bile related issues will be totally calmed down because of this Bhastrika, as well as it is also good pranayam to the people who wants to do this Kundalini awakening exercises, especially in the spirituality, especially in the tantric sadhan, and even in the yoga also. It is advised that doing Bhastrika is always good for the people who wants to awakening their internal dormant energies. But especially here I would like to mention this one, Vata Pitta Slashma Haram. Actually PCOD or PCOS or menstrual disorders connected to the Vata Dosha. It's a kind of internal wind issues. if once you will be more active while doing this pranayamas and mandhas and mudras, so not less than 2 weeks to 3 weeks, you will see that wonderful results. Okay, coming to practices, keep your body straight. And starting our Kapalabhati, if you have any health issues related ears or related blood pressure or related heart ailments or any throwing sensations, choose slow pace of doing or avoid the practices, but always associate with your yoga teacher and physician to take good advice from them. And now coming to Kapalabhati, then starting our 10 strokes first, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, then one small pause for your healthy inhalations and exhalations. Now second spell starting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, again one small break to recover time, take a long pause. Then third last spell of Kapalabhati starting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, just maintain a long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. So after Kapalabhati, use a small break time to give that healthy inhalation and exhalation. Then after that, coming to Bhastrika Pranayama, it is a opposite side formation of the Kapalabhati. It's a sharp inhalation, slow exhalation. Here also contraindications are, like if you have ear problems or any other problems inside the face or throwing sensations or blood pressure issues or heart ailments or any other sickness, choose slow pace of doing or complete avoid the practices. Now coming to Bhastrika Sadhan, keep your body straight. Now starting inhalation, sharp inhalations, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, just take a long deep inhalation and breathe out. Alright, second spell starting then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, again few seconds break. Then after a quick recovering time, then last spell towards 30th stroke, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, then again few seconds break, but still we have a last exercise, Pranakriya Pranayam or rapid inhalations. It is a combination of Kapalabhati and Bhastrika Pranayam, but somewhat it will give more strain, especially on the breath system, so that according to your convenience and your health you can choose this exercise. But it is a very good wonderful exercise to create good balance inside the abdominal organs and lower abdominal organs also. It is a combination of sharp inhalation, sharp exhalation, Kapalabhati and Bhastrika, what we generally called as Pranakriya Pranayam or rapid breathing. Keep your body straight. So here also we are doing 10 strokes, 10 inhalations, 10 exhalations at a go. Then after the small break, again 10 plus 10, small break, again last 10 plus 10, small break. Then starting our exercises. Then fuse against break. Then again we are doing the same exercise pattern, rapid inhalations, rapid exhalations. And in a single go we are doing 10 inhalations, 10 exhalations, starting relaxation. Then one long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. So when you have any issues with your breath, just keep your both the palms down. Once keep your head down, then slowly inhalation, lift your head, and exhalation, slowly keep them down. So this giddiness is very common while doing these rapid inhalations and exhalations. Then right, come back, keep your body straight. Then starting our last exercise, same rapid inhalations, exhalations, then starting. Then slowly break, relaxation. The same thing, when you feel any kind of giddiness, immediately slightly keep your body slant forward with the palms support, with the arm support, lift your head with inhalations, and with exhalations bring them down. Inhalations, lift your chin, exhalation, then very slowly come back. All right, so in a short period you will be all right, but still remember, if this giddiness is beyond the control, immediately relax in shavasana. So it's because of blood fluctuations, because of this rapid inhalations, exhalations, right? Take a long, deep, slow inhalation, exhalation. Soon after your practices, pranayama practices, like you can directly shift your practices towards your dharana exercises if you know well, or you can choose concentration practices through the trataka format. Once you will able to finish these two exercises, or at least one, you can choose some more time to give relaxation to the body and mind through power nap or through nidra yoga or yoga nidra abhyas. And it is also advised to give 15 minutes to 20 minutes time to take bath once you totally finished your yoga exercises, based on your exercise strength, based on the intensity of your practices, the calculations time will be changed. Maybe some people can take 20 minutes to half an hour time to take bath also, but that totally depend on the exercises level. Then once you will be finish your yoga exercises, and after 15 to 20 minutes time and a half an hour time, take bath and further give 10 minutes time to take breakfast. And evening, afternoon, before your lunch hour, see all the possibilities to take a power nap or yoga nidra abhyas. You can do in sitting on the chair also. Instead of jumping to the mobile work or unwanted gossipings, you can choose relaxation by closing your ears when you are in the offices, before your food section. Okay, at least after food session also you can take relaxation. It will improve the concentration levels, it will regenerate the body, and basically it will improve the productivity from you. You will be more active towards evenings. And towards evening, in the evening, once you will able to finish your regular activities before your dinner time, so again try to create at least 15 minutes to half an hour schedule self yoga exercises, to do your self yoga exercises, and inverted postures, simple inverted postures and simple back bending postures also, along with your breathing and breathe out pattern. And when we are meeting here the same time, same place, same topic on Monday, we will see still more exercises on other kind of disorder, how to encounter through Ayurveda and through yoga. We will see still more applications from Monday. So until then, take care of yourself, stay away from the bad habits, and do yoga also. Thanking you all to giving me this wonderful opportunity.